Good day, children. Today in this video, we will see the poem Invictus by William Ernest Henley. Invictus means unconquerable or undefeated in Latin. Out of the night that covers me, black as the pit from pole to pole, I thank whatever gods may be for my unconquerable soul. So what is the poet saying here? Out of the night that covers me, the night is covering him like dark times of the poet. Dark times means sad and unhappy life. Yeah, black as the pit from pole to pole. Pit means coal mine, like a large deep hole, that is what we call it as pit. From pole to pole, everywhere he sees a large deep hole. From pole to pole means everywhere, from top to bottom and everywhere. But the poet, he is thanking God for his unconquerable soul. I thank whatever the gods may be, for my unconquerable soul. Unconquerable means a mind and spirit that cannot be beaten. Yes, a strong mind, a strong soul. Yes, in the fell clutch of circumstances, I have not winced nor cried aloud. Under the bludgeonings of chance, my head is bloody but unbowed. So the poet says that even though he was in the fell clutch, it's like deadly grip, yes, of situation, that is circumstances, he have not winced, made a shrinking movement of the body out of pain or distress. He did not wince nor cried aloud. He didn't even cry. Under the bludgeonings of chance, my head is bloody but unbowed. What do you mean by that? Under the bludgeonings, bludgeoning means beating done with a thick stick nor heavy object. Yeah, of chance. Yes, someone is beating the chance like that. My head is bloody, full of blood, but still unbowed. I'm not bowing my head to anyone. Yes. So the speaker, he says that in this stanza, he says that in the fell clutch of circumstances, even though it is a deadly grip, I have not winced nor cried aloud. I didn't cry, or I didn't make any movement of the body out of pain or distress. Under the bludgeonings of chance, it's been beaten done with thick stick nor heavy object on the chance, but my head is bloody. What happened? My head is full of blood, but it is unbowed. Beyond this place of warmth and tears looms but the horror of the shade, and yet the menace of the years finds and shall find me unafraid. So in this paragraph, the poet has said that beyond the place of warmth and tears, that is, the place of warmth and tears refers to the world of the living, yeah, in which he is both angry and sad. Warmth is like great anger, and tears, sad. The horror of the shade, in another words, is horror of the death. Shade here means death. Yeah, horror of the death, in which one becomes a shade or shadow. Yeah, and yet the menace of the years, a person or a thing that is likely to cause harm. Yet the menace of the years, finds and shall find me unafraid. Still it is finding him as unafraid. After so many years also, it will find me unafraid. It matters not how straight the gate, how the passage is. It doesn't matter. How charged with punishments with the scroll. How charged with punishment the scroll means what happens to him in life. Whatever happens to him in life. I am the master of my fate and I am the captain of my soul. Whatever happens in my life, whatever decision I have made only will come as my fate and for the soul. So I will be the master of my fate. Fate is like the events in someone's life that will happen to them no matter what they do. They have no control over them. Yes, but here the fate is like that. But the poet says that he is master of his own fate. And I am the captain of my soul. He is the captain of his life. Yes. He suffered a tubercular infection when he was in his early 20s. This resulted in an amputation of a leg below the knee. Amputation means surgery or illness. Henley was in great pain for 20 months and he wrote Invictus and other poems during this time. Invictus is Latin for unconquerable or invisible, undefeated soul. Yes, the theme of the poem is to find the strength to overcome problems and difficulties. The speaker gives thanks for his unconquerable soul because although he suffers a great injury, he does not give up. Thank you, children. William Ernest Henley, 1849 to 1903, was a famous poet, critic and editor of the late Victorian era in England. He suffered a tubercular infection when he was in the early 20s. This resulted in an amputation of a leg below the knee. That is, amputation means surgery of the leg below the knee. Henley was in great pain of 20 months and he wrote Invictus and other poems during this time. Invictus is Latin for unconquerable, invisible, undefeated. The theme of the poem is to find the strength to overcome problems and difficulties. The speaker gives thanks for his unconquerable soul because although he suffers a great injury, he does not give up. Thank you, children.